Hello, I'm Petty Officer Bishaw.
And I'm Petty Officer Schmid. Today we're going to be discussing contributing factors that result in contaminated hydraulic sampling.
In today's Navy, hydraulic sampling and analysis in aviation is imperative for the preservation of our aircraft, and we'll be going over some practices for ensuring the best sample collection.
Utilizing the applicable application and maintenance diagnostics and repair tool will help with the successful completion of this task.
Safety is paramount and our most important concern. When out on the flight line, be aware of your surroundings for moving aircraft and support equipment, as well as wearing your proper protective equipment.
When taking a hydraulic sample, whether it is on the aircraft or a piece of support equipment, you want to ensure that the sampling ports are wiped clean and free of any visible debris which will degrade the sample.
This is one of the more important steps of the sampling process.
Accurate determination of hydraulic contaminant levels requires proper sampling techniques. The cleanliness of tools, equipment, and work surfaces are extremely important when opening up the system for maintenance and repairs so contamination does not have the opportunity to make its way into the system. Negative sample results leads to rework and loss of maintenance man hours.
Check the sample bottle for clarity and remove any dirt, debris, or other contaminants by wiping with clean disposable wiping cloths. If the bottle is cloudy or has severe contaminants, it is imperative to get a new bottle and repeat the process. Keeping the hydraulic fluid stored at a consistent temperature will help prevent moisture intrusion through condensation, so make sure bottle lids are secure and tight.
To start the sampling process, initiate the hydraulic fluid flow into a suitable waste receptacle. This will flush any contaminants in the sampling line for mechanical operations.
Once you take an initial sample from the support equipment or aircraft, use the hydraulic fluid taken to rinse the cap and sample bottle threads. This process will assist in the removal of contaminants before taking the final sample.
Lastly, take the final sample to be analyzed. Make sure to fill the sample bottle to the shoulder or fill line. If this is not done, there could be the possibility of not enough fluid to run the sample analysis. Affixing a tag or label identifying aircraft or equipment will help when having to separate multiple samples from different aircraft or equipment.
Prior to sample processing, we want to visually examine the sample for water contamination. Allowing the sample to sit for 10 minutes may facilitate the formation of water droplets if water is present. Water or any other contaminants can degrade the integrity of the aircraft or the support equipment hydraulic systems, which leads to maintenance tasks and man hours that could have been prevented.
Following maintenance procedures correctly ensures that when taking hydraulic samples, there is no rework, your aircraft and support equipment are operational and ready for when your squadron needs it to complete the mission.
From CNATT Lemoore, I'm Petty Officer Bishaw.
And I'm Petty Officer Schmidt. Have a fine Navy day.
Thanks for watching this video, and don't forget to fill out the survey down below in the comments section and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and also feel free to leave comments there.